zero.
We know that very young you compose small pieces for piano and such as percussion.
Not only for piano.
What? Okay.
My
question
is, I tried piano.
Okay. My question is, did you continue to composing not only for piano and later in your successful career?
I stopped about 25 years ago. After I had tried different instruments, pretty much all different styles, and felt that I didn't know what to do next. And that actually coincided with the beginning of my performing career, so I guess that was meant to be so. Now, the more I play and listen to Chopin's, Bach's, Mozart's, Beethoven's, Brahms's, etc. music, the less I want to compose myself.
For example, opinion about Ligeti's etudes.
I'm not one of those who always has a definite opinion about everything. There are many question marks for me in life in general and in music in particular. About many things, I simply don't know the answers. It takes time. And with certain pieces of music, it also takes time for me to get into them, to develop a taste for them, so to speak. This applies to music of different styles and different epochs. For instance, that was the case for me with Rachmaninoff's Symphonic Dance. To give you but one example. Or with, say, Maskovsky's Third Piano Sonata.
It's a very honest answer, and it's a pleasure to see that you have also doubts and unanswered questions, as we all do, especially our students.
On the other hand, as a teenager, I, like many people around me, used to be very infatuated with Alfred Schmidt's music. And now, as years went by, I'm no longer that enthusiastic about it.
And I would like to ask you something about your concert repertoire. We all know that you have a really big discography and even more concerts repertoire. So how do you choose your recitals, pieces for your recitals? And how much time you spend on learning pieces before you are playing them in the public?
Choosing pieces is not difficult. As we all know, the piano repertoire is immensely vast. Choosing, building up programs is much more difficult, a process which, again, as we all know too well, involves many different factors. My tastes are and have always been very broad. So I just try to create listenable programs from musical works I love and want to play. And your second question was?
My second question actually was, do you have any particular works of composers which you would like to play in the future and you didn't play?
I think you asked something else. Oh, yes. Well, I don't do that in one go. I usually start about a year in advance, work on a new program or piece for several weeks, then put it aside for several weeks or several months, then come back to it. This is the way I do that. Are there many pieces I have not played and would love to play? Many more than those I have already played.
Let's say, for example, you read in your interview about Bach. You said that
Bach, there are still many Haydn sonatas, Mozart sonatas, some Mozart concertos, many Beethoven sonatas as well, well as variation cycles. Some Schubert sonatas, like the D major one, for example, which I'm very fond of and will definitely play.
Okay,
the French impressionists, as well as the European 20th century music, as well as some chamber music works. Of all the Beethoven trios, I've only played Der Geister. I'd love to play Brahms' quintet, Shostakovich's quintet and trio.
It's nice to hear that you haven't played everything yet.
I hope I live long enough to play everything.
I'm sure of that.
The way I want to play.
That's the most important thing. Thank you, Brescia. We have a hall full of young pianists. Everybody's practicing and wanted to be like you. What would you say in here? What kind of advice you can give him for their life, for their careers? What's...
If anyone who does not know you personally, who does not know how you play, what kind of life you have, what kind of problems you have, starts giving you a piece of advice, send him or her to hell.
Your impressions being in Croatia, staying in Croatia, meeting Croatian people. How did you experience our country?
This has been one of the most enjoyable and will remain one of the most memorable experiences of my life. Unique, warm, hospitable reception, and I already look forward to to my next visit to your wonderful city.